Whew, this is gonna be a long one, but hopefully it will be a comprehensive guide because in this video I will show you A, the building blocks of making a cream, B, how to tweak the formula to turn it into a cream or a lotion, and C, how to fix the soaping effect many experience with some emulsifiers, particularly Olivem 1000. So broadly, a successful cream contains water or hydrosol, oil, an emulsifier or several, stabilizers such as gums and fatty alcohols, preservative, antioxidants like vitamin E, pH stabilizers such as citric acid or baking soda, and finally, all the lovely active ingredients you can fit in a cream. These ingredients are grouped together in phases. Some are heated, some are added at the end, at the cooling stage, but eventually all of these phases will be combined together. Now let me walk you through the ingredients a little bit more. So for the water, I go for distilled water or hydrosols. It's important to note that you cannot just use water from the tap because it can contain bacteria and viruses. If you don't have distilled water or hydrosols at hand, make sure to boil the water for at least 20 minutes. The thing with boiled water though is that while it is good at killing bacteria, it will not remove the minerals in that water, which can destabilize the formula after a while. But there's something called a chelator which can help remedy that by binding to the minerals in that water and preventing it from messing with your cream. Oil is of course another key component of any cream. You can combine oils or just opt for one oil, but the choice of oils is important because you want to make sure that it's not comedogenic, meaning that it will block your pores. For example, coconut oil for some is very comedogenic and can lead to acne, while others it's fine, it's just trial and error, I guess. For me, it works fine on my body, but not on my face. Other types of oils such as jojoba, sunflower, and grapeseed oil are great because they will absorb fast and do not clog pores. Moving on to our emulsifier. For this, I chose Olivem 1000. Is it my favorite emulsifier? No, by far it isn't, but it is a great way to start. It is very skin friendly, it's PEG free and natural, and it's very accessible, so that's why I chose it. It's a great starting point emulsifier to have in your kit. Also common in creams are stabilizers such as fatty alcohols and gums. Xanthan gum is a common gum to use, and it is quite cool since it's made from bacterial fermentation. It is important here to use a cosmetic grade xanthan gum because baking xanthan gum will result in gloopy, unclear formulations. Trust me, I've been there. You don't want to do that. See what I mean? Fatty alcohols are another type of stabilizer, and these are not like ethanol, which is very drying. Fatty alcohols are actually emollients, and they also serve to thicken and stabilize the formula. A classic fatty alcohol is cetyl alcohol or cetyl alcohol. I like palm oil-free fatty alcohols such as brassica or benahyl alcohol. Glycerin is helpful in many ways. First, to disperse the gum so it mixes better with water. Secondly, it has skin benefits because it is a humectant, so it will attract water to the skin. And lastly, also because it attracts and retains water, it will make sure that water stays in our cream and you don't have a cracked up dry cream after a few weeks. Preservation is key. Without it, you're just gonna end up with fungi, bacteria, and all sorts of microorganisms on your skin. You do not want that. It is worse than having a little bit of preservative in your formula. Always make sure that you're using a broad spectrum preservative so you're not missing out on any protection, and also that it is compatible with the final pH of your formula. All these details should always be on the specification sheet of that ingredient provided by the cosmetics ingredient supplier or the manufacturer themselves. Heat-sensitive ingredients like plant extract or highly unsaturated oils are added at the end, at the cool-down stage. Examples are floral waters, lemon zest extract, raspberry CO2 extract, rosehip oil, sea buckthorn oil, panthenol, and so on and so on. The possibilities are endless, and coming up with your own blend is extremely fun. And last but not least, we measure the pH to make sure that it is in line with our skin's own pH of 5.5, and so that the formulation isn't at 2 or 11, which would be way too intense for our skin. Before we move on to the method, I just want to point out that I will be showing you how to make an oil and water formula, which is the most common one out there. Water and oil is another another way to make a cream, which I can show in a future video if you'd like. And this is typically used to make heavier products such as night creams and balms. And the process is a little bit different here, so that's why I'm sticking to oil and water, which is way more applicable to different formulations. So start off by measuring your oil phase in a beaker and heat at about 75 degrees. Next, measure out your water phase and heat it up in the same double boiler. When the oil phase has completely melted, pour the oil into the water phase. With Olivem 1000, you could technically measure, heat, and mix both oil and water phases all in one beaker with the so-called one-pot method. But it isn't like that with every emulsifier, so I wanted to show you the classical method. Stir for a moment for both phases to be combined. Then start cooling off the cream. Alternate between stirring and resting phases. Using a blender is optional. You will get a great cream by hand stirring too, but it is a personal preference. And sometimes it does lead to greater consistency when blended with a machine. When the cream has cooled off, you can add your heat-sensitive ingredients such as vitamin E, preservative, and any extracts. There are three components you can play around with to achieve your desired consistency. Firstly, the emulsifier concentration. Check the manufacturer guidelines as they will tell you which percentages are appropriate for which. Then you can play around with the fatty alcohol concentration. Again, check the manufacturer guidelines since they will provide a range at which you can use this fatty alcohol as a co-emulsifier. Finally, your choice of oils will also influence the consistency, and especially butters such as cocoa butter or shea butters are great examples. And now it is time to enjoy this cream, which is gonna feel so nice to put on. Wait, what was that? Seems like we have a case of soaping over here. This phenomenon occurs when the emulsifier is catching air during application, resulting in microfoam. This can occur with natural high HLB emulsifiers such as Olivem 1000. HLB just means hydrophilic lipophilic balance and is basically an indicator of how good an emulsifier will bring two opposing elements such as oil and water together. So basically, Olivem 1000 is just too good at emulsifying that it goes into overdrive. The soaping effect can be worsened by other ingredients such as fatty alcohols and gums because they create drag on the skin. So yes, while some emulsifiers do need thickeners and stabilizers so that the cream holds together for a few months, others are good on their own and honestly way better without them. I now present you with three tweaks to get rid of the soaping effect, or at least reduce it. Number one is, you guessed it, leave out gums and fatty alcohols altogether. This will not completely reduce the soaping effect, but it definitely won't make it much worse. Tip number two is adding a low HLB emulsifier such as Olivem 900, which has anti-foaming properties. And finally, you can use oils that reduce drag. Examples of this include shea butter, hydrogenated oils, or squalane. So if I were to create my ideal Olivem 1000 cream, it would look like this. And for a lotion, it would look like this. Hydrogenated rapeseed oil is not a must, and you can substitute it with something else such as shea butter or squalane, depending on how thick you want the cream. I didn't really add extracts in this one to let you customize it as you want. Make sure you know if your extracts are oil or water soluble to keep the formula balanced. So say you want to add 1% raspberry seed oil extract, which is oil soluble, you would then deduct that from the jojoba oil. If you want to add 1% lemon zest extract, which is water soluble, you would deduct the water. So hopefully this gave you a good understanding about how to make a cream and gave you a good starting point for working with Olivem 1000, since I know how disheartening it can be to make a formula, get all excited about it, and then it going badly. I tried everything under the sun with this emulsifier and I'm so happy it turned out the way it did. Please consider liking and subscribing if you got any value from this, so I know I'm going in the right direction. See you in the next one!